Dear students, you will see the part 3. So, in the last class, we learnt about contingency, outage, energy management system, and we came across that there should be some control strategy to avoid such problems. So, we have got 6 levels of security. The security levels of system. Level 1 is also called as a secure level. Level 2, correctively secure. Level 3, that is the alert level. Level 4, correctable emergency. Level 5, non-correctable emergency. Level 6, restorative level. So these are the 6 security levels of the system. So one by one we will see. So before this, you should know few terms. So until unless you know these terms, it will be very much difficult for you to understand all these 6 levels of security. So we have got 2 important terms. The first term is violation of limits, and the second term is the load loss. So not going to much detail, with a simple example, with this illustration, we will see what is the violation of limits and what is load loss. Let us see. So we have got 2 generators shown. Generator 1, which having the capacity of 10 megawatt, and generator 2 having the which can generate the power of 10 megawatt. So we have got 2 buses, bus 1 and bus 2. So the upper line capacity is 5 megawatt and the lower line capacity is 5 megawatt. And the load, that is the load required, is 20 megawatt. So in this condition, if we see these 2 generators, they will generate 10 megawatt plus 10 megawatt. This is a normal safe condition. The power generator is 10 megawatt plus 10 megawatt, that is 20 megawatt. Load also that is required is 20 megawatt. So in such condition, no violation of any limits. So these are not violating any of the limits. And the second is, there is no load loss. So this is a normal condition, safe condition and a secure condition. This is case 1. Let us go to the second case. So in this case, as we see, the same generators having the upper line and lower line. So in this case, there is some fault in the lower line. Means this line, there is some fault. There will be no supply from this line. So there is a line fault. So in such case, the upper line, the capacity of upper line is 5 megawatt, but it carries extra load of 5 megawatts. Thus, it carries a power of 10 megawatts, such that the same 20 megawatt power is delivered to the load. 10 megawatt from this generator 2, and this from the upper line, this 10 megawatt from this, that is total power that is supplied to the load is 20 megawatt. Such condition is termed as violating the limit, but no load loss. Means the same desired 20 megawatt, required 20 megawatt is delivered at the load. But the thing is that upper line capacity is 5 megawatt, but it has violated the limit. So such condition, we have crossed the limits, means we have violated the limit, but there is no load loss. Let us see the case 3. So in this case 3, the same thing, but here there is some fault, there is some fault in the lower line, lower transmission line. There is a fault, so upper line will carry 5 megawatt only, not like in the case 2 when it carries 10 megawatt, such that 15 megawatt power is delivered at the load. Means 5 from the generator 1, 10 from the generator 2. Such condition is termed as no limits were violated. Means this 5, it did not go to 10, it was just transmitting the power of 5 megawatt only. So such condition is termed as no limits were violated, but there was a load loss. Means the load required was 20 megawatt, but there was a 5 megawatt loss. So such condition is here that there is a load loss, but no limits were violated. So these are the three cases, three conditions. If you know all these things very clearly, then it is very easy to understand the six levels of security. Now let us see the six levels of security. Level one, that is a secure level. So I have made it something like green so that it looks like it is safe. So at this level, the load is supplied without violating any limits. None of the contingency will cause any violations of the system parameters. That is the level 1. That is, it's called secure level. Level 2, that is also called correctively secured level. So all load is supplied without violating any limits as in the level 1. Contingencies do not cause any load loss if an appropriate control action is taken. It is more economical to run the system at this level rather than level 1, but relies on the corrective actions taken after post contingency. Means after any contingency, whatever action, corrective action is being taken. So level 1 is a secure level. Level 2 is correctively secured level. Now let us see level 3. So level 3, it is an alert level. Here, load is still supplied without violating limits as in level 1 and level 2. But contingency causes some violations which cannot be corrected without loss of load. The system can be brought back to level 1 or level 2 by preventive rescheduling. What the level 3 is? It is an alert level. Here, load is still supplied without violating limits. There is no violation of limits. So as in level 1 and level 2, but contingencies causes some violations which cannot be corrected without loss of load. The system can be brought back to level 1 or level 2 by preventive rescheduling. Level 4 is also called correctable emergency. Here all load is supplied, but with operating limits violated. Here, operating limits are violated. These violations cannot be corrected without loss of load. The system can be brought back to level 3 by corrective actions. What is this level 4? Level 4 is a correctable emergency. Here, all the load is supplied, but with operating limits are violated. These violations cannot be corrected without loss of load. The system can be brought back to level 3 by corrective actions. Next, coming to level 5. Level 5 is non-correctable emergency. All loads are supplied with violations of operating limit. See, all load are supplied with violation of operating limits. The situation can be corrected only by loss of load. The duration and amount optimized by an optional power flow program. That is level 5. Now, that is the last level. That is restorative level. Level 6. Level 6, operating limits are not violated, but the system is operating with loss of load. Restorative control brings it back to level 1 or level 2. Level 6 is also called as restorative level. The operating limits are not violated, but the system is operating with loss of load. Restorative control brings it back to level 1 and level 2.